Anniversary with the theme Keeping Alive the Valor of the Heroes of World War II.
Good evening, everyone. How much we treasure your coming over and joining us for this dinner, Baril Fiesta, we call, hosted by the municipality of Palau. We welcome you. We love your coming over. This is the traditional Barrio Fiesta hosted by the municipality of Palau every time there's a celebration or commemoration of the Lake Inn golf landings. You will still also be here with us and years to come, I hope. So tonight, let me welcome all of you. I have not mentioned who are here. I hope there's still a lot of them. And the families of our new veterans, sons and daughters, barangay captains, guests, all the way and spared a little bit of time with their busy lives to join us for this commemoration. And we greet from the country of Japan, may I welcome Minister Takehiro Kano, Deputy Chief of Mission and Head of Political Section, Embassy of Japan, Kasunobu Akutsu, Defense Attaché, Embassy of Japan. May I welcome as well and greet tonight from the country of Australia, Mr. Matheson Kimberley, Deputy Head of Mission, Embassy of Australia. From the United States of America, this is the hardest to pronounce, Mr. Michael Kuliczewski, Deputy Chief of Mission, Embassy of the United States. Other members of the party of our guests tonight, we also have with us, and we wish to really welcome them tonight, our Veterans Federation of the Philippines in Manila, Colonel Bonifacio De Grasso, Justice Manuel Pamaran, who's always here with us. Today, we commemorate an event 73 years ago, which we will never forget, which forever will be in our hearts and in our minds, because it is one event in the whole world where people got the taste of peace once again and liberty and freedom. MacArthur, General Douglas MacArthur, landed in the shores of Palau Leyte. We personally came down in Palau, but the whole area from Tacloban up to Abuyong, the whole area of the Pacific seas were covered with soldiers and boats and guns and all that. And General Douglas MacArthur stepped down in the shores of Palau. That's why we never cease and we never fail to celebrate, to commemorate this very special day. Gave us freedom at the expense, of course, of people dying, of our loved ones who died, and everyone else. That we will all be there. There will be a lot of activities too. And This is also prelude to the 75th commemoration on the 75th anniversary that will be in 2019. It will be a big celebration, perhaps as the golden anniversary was celebrated, this would be the diamond anniversary, and we shall be preparing for a lot of very meaningful and significant activities. We hope that you will continue to come. You will also be here for the 75th. Let's enjoy each other's company. We shall be entertained by some songs and music. But best of all is the fact that we are all here gathered together, knowing that 73 years ago, a very big and important event happened on the shores of Baloy. And this we shall always remember. So thank you for coming, enjoy the evening, and be with us as well tomorrow in the commemoration. Thank you very much.
Patila, all the Patilas who are here tonight, my colleagues from the Diplomatic Corps for being here, and I look forward to participation in the first commemoration, for my first commemoration of the Leyte landing tomorrow, and look forward to commemorating all of the veterans and others who participated, not there, but countries that participated. Mr. Governor, and really appreciate being here. Thank you.
And good evening, everyone. Like the ambassador has just said, from Australia as well, I think the opportunity to be welcomed here so warmly by your excellencies, both by all of the officials at the airport, at the hotel, and then here this evening. Good to see my colleagues from the Diplomatic Corps, and especially the veterans and the community of this fantastic part of the Philippines. It's an honour to be back. It's not my first visit. I'm very pleased to be back, but last time was such a quick trip, I didn't really get time to see anything properly of Tacloban and Palo well. So today was a good chance this afternoon, and I look forward to tomorrow. Tonight and tomorrow, though, are all about partnership and commitment and remembering sacrifice. And I think this event and the plans for tomorrow really put that into perspective. As John just said, the region and indeed parts of the Philippines face particular challenges at the minute, but by continuing to follow the legacy of the people that have gone before us, working together, working hard at providing peace and prosperity, every chance of success. And it's pleasing that things down south are looking like they're going to be resolved shortly, and then the hard work will really begin with the recovery operations. And I say that on behalf of my country and those that are also, I'm sure, here with us. We're all there with the Philippines to help you do that. But I think this event and you, the community here in Palo, as you do every year, I know, honour the commitment and the memory and the sacrifice of those veterans. We do well to remember the reasons that we were here at those times, and we should learn those lessons, all of us. So I look very much forward to tomorrow and meeting you all tonight. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Mr. Matheson, Kimberly.
This time, let's listen to the message of Minister Takahiro Kano, Deputy Chief of Mission, Head of Political Section, Embassy of Japan.
Good evening, our guests and our hosts. Thank you very much for your warm hospitality, and it's my great pleasure and honor to be here. This is my first visit to Leyte. Actually, I was assigned in Manila just 2 months ago, and I'm relatively new to this country, but my first encounter to this country is back to 20 years ago when our embassy was newly built in Manila, and then I visited Manila, Davao, and Cebu, but Leyte was the place that I really wanted to come. Because of the historic events that took place decades ago. When I served in other foreign posts in the US or in Europe, one of my approach to understand the host country is to visit the battlefields. because when you visit the battlefields and then reflect on what happened there, that gives me a lot of inspiration and how things affected. And in the US, I visited a lot of civil war sites, and also when I was in Europe, there are so many other battlefields. But in the Philippines, I think this is the one that people like us should never forget. So I read the history book on the Battle of Leyte when I was in Tokyo, and I had some knowledge, but I didn't have a hands-on experience. So I'd like to spend tonight and tomorrow reflecting on what happened, and then meeting with people like you and veterans in particular, and then learn from each other the lessons of the history. And thank you very much again, and look forward and see you tomorrow evening too. Thank you.
We are truly honored to have the defense attaché, Embassy of Japan, to give his message to you.
Good evening, and thank you very much. This year also received the invitation from the municipality panel, and this is the second time for me to visiting to the municipality of the panel. And last year I remember about that I also joined this dinner, and I could enjoy a lot of the cultural dance and song, and I felt a lot of the Bisayan Lakes culture and hospitality. And this year also, of course, for Japan, we cannot forget the tragic history, but this year also just to develop our economic activity and hope the Ministry of Power and Leyte province also have the good prosperity for the good future. And just last to the Mayor Patilia mentioned about the upcoming the big event, the 75th ceremony in 2019. And just I watched this seal, the Ministry of Power, the 1768. I didn't know about this history. So this means that next year maybe the anniversary is 250. So this is also next year also big event. And I hope next year also I want to come here and I want to celebrate the Ministry of Power. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Colonel Kazuhubu Akutsu.
We call on Mr. Michael S. Kucheski, Embassy of the United States.
And that's how I call him Filipino. That's why I have to protect myself. And I have a Filipino mother-in-law as well, so it's important to know the language. It's my great pleasure to be here. I was here 20 years ago, celebrating actually the same thing, and it brings back all kinds of fond memories. But I was just thinking, over the course of this day, about this day and tomorrow, and I guess there are three things I just want to say, and I promise to be extremely brief. So there are three things that I guess this evokes, for me at least, and I think for all of us. And one of them is tradition, because it's very important that we continue to remember what happened those countless decades ago, and as was already noted, to remember the horrors of war and try to avoid those horrors in the future. And in that connection, I'll just say that we had a little bit of very pleasant dose of tradition this afternoon. We went to visit the church in Tacloban. We heard fire alarms, police sirens. It turns out that the parade was taking place in Tacloban, celebrating this occasion. So it was really nice to see old American Jeeps and new Filipino fire trucks, and a great deal else. It was a real pleasure, and really we admire the fact that this is remembered every year, and it's part of a great tradition. It's very, very important. The second thing that kind of it evokes from me is courage, and I would say the word grit. Partly because whenever you think, at least when we Americans think about Douglas MacArthur, the first thing we think about, of course, is the famous words, "I shall return." And it symbolizes that courage and that grit that is something that everybody admires. And in that connection, I will say that the courage and the grit that we have seen from the people of Leyte province in the years after Typhoon Haiyan is something that is also tremendously admired. I think all of us from countries that were able to help you were delighted, honored that we could help. But it's you that suffered through this and that show the courage, the spirit that I think is admired throughout the world. And finally is alliance, friendship among countries. And that again is something tremendously important. And it's another thing that was evoked for us when we think about the Filipino-American alliance of those years, and one that continues, and I think it's something that's shared by my fellow diplomats. So it's a very moving 2 days for us, and I really feel honored to be here. Let's enjoy the rest of the evening. Thank you so much.
Our governor of the province of Leyte, Honorable
Leopoldo
Domenico Loredo Petila.
A pleasant good evening to everybody. The members of the diplomatic corps who are here today. Of course, my elder sister, the mayor of Palo, Mayor Mate Petila. Just a few years age difference. And our I will not name all because I noticed that after my speech, it's already dinner. So I think everybody's already ready to attack. So I'll not mention everybody. So we have the veterans, the members of the Veterans Federation of the Philippines. We have from the American Legion Auxiliary, the Philippines. Sons and daughters, and our local chapters of the Veterans Federation of the Philippines, board members, government, my fellow workers in government, a pleasant good evening to everybody. What I can say is 73 years ago, tomorrow, 73 years ago, many soldiers have made the ultimate sacrifice. They made sacrifice, they died so that others may live. No? And all the valor, the courage that mentioned earlier, valor, gallantry, all these, and heroism, everything in its volume, in large volumes. But we're all here in the lands of Leyte. So it is important that we commemorate that event. It is important that we give honor to our heroes who we lost 70 years ago, and those who survived, who are some of them are here, still here with us tonight. No? Very important because I think it is those traits of our soldiers that we have acquired also from our soldiers, we are able to survive. No? We are able to use and was very useful for us to survive during the typhoon, that monstrous typhoon. No? And I agree with agree ako sa iyo, sir, sa sinabi mo. No? And it is for those of us who live because of their death, it's just right. It is our duty to honor them. It is our duty to thank them. And I think what the best way to thank them is really not only to live but to love each other and to succeed in our daily lives. To make our country, to build a better country, to build a better world for everybody. And if we succeed in that area, I'm quite sure our heroes watching over us till this day will really clap and be happy watching us succeed. And I'm quite sure when we recover very fast from Uganda, I'm quite sure they were very happy seeing us. Not only those who helped us, a lot of you who are here today has helped us, helped our region recover from Uganda. And not only those who helped us are happy, but also those are heroes who died 73 years ago. So just to let you know, before Uganda, okay, our region, the Eastern Visayas region, has been ranked as the second poorest region. And right after Uganda, we became the poorest region of the 17 regions in the country. But just 2 years later, by the end of 2015, we were ranked again, this time as the third. Still a long way to go to 17, but definitely we are on our way there and very fast. Why? Because, in other words, before Uganda we were second, and by the end of 2015 we were third. It means by the end of 2015 we were already better than we were before Uganda. And last year, the regional economy of Region 8 grew by 12.4%. And that is the fastest GDP growth among the 17 regions in the country. No? Coming out of the ruins of Uganda. And I'm quite sure we will be able to sustain that. No? With the strength of the Litenos, with the will to survive, and with the lessons we learned 73 years ago. And so, everybody, again, don't forget, let's give honor. Let us not forget. Every year we commemorate to make sure that we will not do it again. We'll not do war again. And as MacArthur said, again, I shall return. I always like to hear that word, I shall return, especially our tourists who come here. Our guests who are here, I know once you leave Leyte, you will say, I shall return. And if there are two things that I do not want to hear saying, I shall return, is one is war. And of course, we don't really want to hear Yolanda say, I shall return. So, mabuhay tayo na. Maraming salamat.